ETSI is a trade association which is based in Europe. It's the European Telecommunications Standards Institute. Our role in life is to write standards which form the basis then of telecommunications deployment worldwide. But in the context of this show, you might well ask, why is a European standards body coming to the US? And the answer to that in the context of 4G is very clear. The predominant 4G standard is LTE, long-term evolution, and that standard is derived from a group called 3GPP, the Third Generation Partnership Project. And 3GPP is founded by a number of standards bodies throughout the world, of which the European partner is indeed ETSI. The North American partner is our neighbor on the next stand, which is ATIS. And together we provide, together with partners in Korea, China and Japan, the infrastructure in which 3GPP then operates. Our presence here is not to promote the Institute. We're not doing institutional promotion here. What we're hoping to do is to encourage industry to take a more active role in the writing of LTE standards. In general, we find that industry falls into one of two camps. They are either standards makers or standards takers. And what we would prefer is that, certainly from a North American point of view, industry takes more of an active role in becoming standards makers. So they actually bring their intellect to the committees and ensure that their bright ideas are actually encapsulated in what becomes the mobile networks of tomorrow. So that's the prime purpose to be here, is to inform the US population of how the 4G standards are being written and how they can play a more active role in moulding and shaping those standards. Several years ago, the prediction was that the first to market would either be NTT Docomo in Japan or Verizon in the US. And I think it's very typical of our industry that most of the predictions we make tend to be wrong. And it was very wrong in this case, because from nowhere came TeliaSonera about 12 months ago. Here in the US, we see Metro PCS having launched. We know Verizon is about to launch. In Japan, NTT Docomo are just about to launch. We know AT&T have said they will launch in the middle part of next year, perhaps. And we're expecting US Cellular to do a very similar thing. It's significant if you look at the commercial test networks that we have available, the many, many test networks that are really on the cusp of commercialization. So I think if we watch the next 6 months, you'll see some very, very interesting releases and networks becoming live and operational. So I think the US has an important role to play in this for sure.